Demonstrators rally in Europe in solidarity with US protesters.
Here's a summary of the article.
In an interview on Fox this morning, Pompeo called the actions by the police officers in George Floyd's killing abhorrent and said the administration had moved very quickly in responding, pointing to comments from President Trump and Attorney General Bill Barr. Pompeo said that the violence at the protests came from Antifa-like violent protests, but noted, it still remains to be seen exactly how what began as peaceful protests by people who were clearly saddened and frustrated by the police action against George Floyd turned violent. New York City Police Commissioner Dermot Shea said is extremely proud of the way officers carried themselves over the last few days as protests erupted around the city. Some context out of New York City, more than 340 people were arrested across the city during protests that started Saturday and lasted into Sunday morning, a senior NYPD official told CNN, at least 33 officers were injured during the protest, some of them seriously injured, the official said. Nearly 48 police vehicles were damaged or destroyed during the protest. Washington, D.C., Mayor Muriel Bowser said Sunday that protesters have the right to exercise their First Amendment right but not to destroy our city, after the city experienced its second night of protests and some looting Saturday. Some context, on Saturday Trump wrongly accused Bowser in a tweet of not allowing the D.C. Metropolitan Police Department to help the Secret Service keep control of the situation with protesters in Lafayette Park the night before. More than 340 people were arrested across New York City during protests that started Saturday and lasted into Sunday morning, a senior NYPD official told CNN, at least 33 officers were injured during the protest, some of them seriously injured, the official said.
This post received a score of 23,000, with an upvote ratio of 92%. Here are the top comments in response to this article.
Cops leaving protest shoot paperball at person on the sidewalk, Austin police firing rubber bullets at a peaceful crowd, Omaha, known racist shoots and kills young black protester. Cops rob this man's brand new TV that he bought at Target. If you have anything you'd like to add, please link it.
Come on, man. Link Cincinnati shooting at people sitting down and macing a knocked out dude in the face.
Added.
Thank you and thanks for what you are doing.
I need my guns just so I can resist when the government turns on me. Where are you now? About half are probably laughing at the fact that the enemy is the one being brutalized by the police state. The other half are aware that standing alone would be suicide by cop, and are waiting for things to turn into a life or death scenario.
All these weeks of social distancing, gone just like that. I get the solidarity thing, but if people came out in mass numbers in my I'd tell them to go home and tweet about it. I have never seen a police force so heavily militarized, or a place where it's so normalized like the U.S. Also too, Pompeo calling the protests Antifa-like scares the shit out of me. Sounds like this administration's excuse to just start labeling anyone they want terrorists.
They already announced they will label Antifa as a terrorist organization.
Which is not really doable. 1. Antifa is not an organization. 2. U.S. doesn't have the legal framework for labeling domestic orgs as terrorists due to First Amendment.
If you can declare war on objects like drugs, and ideas like terrorism, you can clearly ban organizations that don't exist.
Funny enough, all over the world in mass revolts police turn into thugs brutally attacking their own people to protect the establishment. The military tends to be the opposite. The U.S. military has stricter rules of engagement than the U.S. police do, and more accountability. The world watches the U.S. military, not so much for the U.S. police.
Also better training.
Yeah, like more than 6 weeks of training.
U.S. Army infantry train for 14 weeks and basic training for other jobs is 9 weeks, I think, plus additional time spent in specialized training. They don't screw around.
All U.S. Army soldiers go through a version of basic training, whether that be one station unit training, OSUT, usually reserved for combat roles, or regular basic combat training, BCT. Both BCT and Stage 1 of OSUT are 10 weeks long, after which OSUT moves into their specialized training, which can be anywhere from an additional 6 to 20 plus weeks of training, and BCT moves to 8 or advanced individual training, where they are taught their job skills. 8 changes by job type but can be anywhere from an additional 6 weeks to over 12 months of training depending on the job.
This video was automatically created by Reddit to speech. The article and comments in this video were selected from Reddit according to their upvotes, and any paraphrasing was performed by smmry.com, without any human intervention.